a person who was the leader of Muslims sent by the Prophet himself, peace and blessing be upon him and his holy progeny, when the Prophet sent number of the Muslims out of Mecca to save them from the torture and harassment and the harm which they used to face from the non-believers. They told them to go and migrate from Mecca to Abyssinia. Abyssinia, that time, was governed by a Christian king by the name of Najashi. The leader of the Muslims appointed by the Prophet was his cousin brother, Jafar ibn Abi Talib. Jafar ibn Abi Talib, the leader of the Muslim migrants, he was in Abyssinia, and he was reciting Quran in front of people there and in front of the king himself, Najashi. And in the history, we find that when Jafar ibn Abi Talib used to recite Quran in front of the king Najashi, Surah Maryam, Najashi used to weep and cry while listening to the great verses in Surah Maryam, because that surah mentioned Maryam and her son Isa, Jesus Christ, alayhi as-salam. So, Ja'far ibn Abi Talib spent time in Abyssinia. And then Ja'far ibn Abi Talib came back after a long journey in Abyssinia, came back to Medina. And he arrived Medina on the same day of the victory of Muslims in Khaybar over the enemies of Islam. When Ja'far ibn Abi Talib reached to Medina, the Prophet received him with lot of respect and love and said openly that, "I don't know, I'm more happy. I'm happy in the return of Ja'far or more in the victory of Khaybar." Imagine the victory of Khaybar, which was a great victory of Islam. The Prophet said, "La adri bi ayyihima ana ashaddu sururan." I don't know in or because of any of these two, I'm more happy, the victory of Khaybar or the return of Ja'far. And the Prophet received him, embraced him, and told him, "Oh Ja'far, shall I gift you?" Ja'far said, "Yes, oh Messenger of Allah." The Prophet told him to pray 4 rak'at of namaz, which is known by Salat Ja'far al-Tayyar, the prayer of Ja'far al-Tayyar. In Sunni books, they call it Salat al-Tasbih, namaz al-Tasbih in Sunni books. And in our books, it's called Salat Ja'far. 4 rak'at with a great reward. Anyone has got any important need can pray this Salat, namaz, 4 rak'at, and he will get his wish. In the first rak'at, Alhamd and Surah, then 15 times, Subhanallah walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Then ruku', Then in the ruku', after the tasbih, after ruku', 10 times, Subhanallah walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. Then standing from ruku', again 10 times of tasbih, then going to sajda. In the sajda, after the tasbih of sajda, 10 times, then sitting from sajda, then 10 times of Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. Then another sajda, and 10 times, then sitting from the second sajda, then 10 times, then standing up for the second rak'at, you will find that in every rak'at, it is 75 times of tasbih. 75 times. So two rak'ats, then two rak'ats. The total number of tasbih will be 300. This is Salat of Jafar al-Tayyar. You can also perform it by performing two rak'at of usual namaz, like morning. Then another two rak'at of namaz, like morning. Then after namaz, recite Subhanallah walhamdulillah 300 times. That is Salat of Ja'far, namaz of Ja'far Tayyar, a great namaz. Ja'far al-Tayyar was murdered in the battle of Mu'ta. Mu'ta is a place which is now in Jordan. And the shrine of Ja'far is still in a city called Karak. Karak in Jordan. The shrine of Ja'far al-Tayyar. Ja'far al-Tayyar, the dear cousin brother, the beloved cousin brother of the Prophet of Islam, and the brother, the real brother of Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali alayhi salam. And he is one of the greatest personalities in the holy family of the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him and his holy progeny. And I remember here a hadith which also includes Ja'far al-Tayyar. The Prophet of Islam, Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alih, in one day after performing morning prayer in the masjid with the jama'at, after namaz, he turned his face to the people and said, "Oh, my companions, I saw last night in my dream my uncle Hamza and my cousin brother Ja'far. I saw them that time, both of them were being martyred, shaheed. I saw them in the paradise. And I saw them, and in front of them was fruit. They used to eat from that fruit. Then after a while, that fruit turned into grapes, another fruit. Mm-hmm. Then after a while, that fruit turned into dates, rotab, fresh dates. I came near them and told them, Bi abi antuma. Look, the Prophet is telling Hamza and Ja'far. Bi abi antuma means, may my father be sacrificed for you. Imagine how great they were. What did you find in the paradise best of reward? What did you find in the paradise best of reward? What deeds which you find its reward is the best? They told me that we found the best deeds and the greatest reward in the paradise for saqiyul ma, giving water. Then as-salatu alayk, reciting salawat on you and Ahlul Bayt, and حب علي بن أبي طالب, the love of علي بن أبي طالب. These are the greatest three good deeds which we found that their reward is the greatest. Giving water and reciting salawat and love for Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. From here, I would like to salute the great Shaheed Jafar al-Tayyar. Tayyar means Allah gave him wings that he flies in the paradise. Tayyar from Tar means fly. Flyer. Allah granted him because both of his arms were chopped while he was fighting the enemies of Islam in the battle of Mu'tah. Allah granted him wings that he flies in the paradise. We say from here, Assalamu alayka ya Ja'far al-Tayyar wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.